say, like, oh, I'd still show up to work. We wouldn't be friends with those people.
I would definitely do a lot of weather, though, on the side, because I love it too much.
Sure, you know? It's your love. It's your passion. Yeah. You've got a lot to talk about in the weather department with the fog. We had that again.
Yeah, we did, actually. Dense at times this morning, though downtown this morning, it wasn't as dense as yesterday morning, but we still had it, and we are locked in the clouds. Depending on where you are this afternoon, it's a cool day. We do have the clouds, especially in the Willamette Valley, and areas still have some pretty dense fog out there. I'll get to the map here in just a second, but let's go ahead and time out the rest of your day for you. In fact, temperatures, we're going to stay on the cool side, and we're not going to cool down too much tonight with the clouds. I think we'll still have patchy areas of fog through the evening hours. Now, once we get into around that 9 p.m. area, we could start to see a little bit of drizzle here in the metro area. Up towards the North Shore, we might even start to see a few showers trying to get in between about 5 and 7 o'clock in the evening hour. So let's go ahead and look outside again. The fog has lifted downtown a little bit. I mean, we still have a pretty low stratus deck right now, and temperatures at 38 degrees. The winds are calm, and you can see on the Willamette River right now, not really much at all in the way of any kind of waves or motion right now, because we just have calm winds out there. 2 miles visibility in Portland, 10 in Vancouver, doing good out towards your direction. Once we get out towards Hillsboro, around 2 and 2.5 in McMinnville, Salem right now looking good at 10 mile visibility. Now, temperatures this morning started in the low 30s, right around 33 in Hillsboro. We haven't warmed up too much. Low to mid 30s out towards downtown, 37, I should say, out towards Hood River and the Dalles. We do have a freezing fog advisory until 1 p.m., but we're starting to see some improvements. Temperatures have gone up a little bit in Hood River, much warmer in Bend with some sunshine. And as we get out towards Tillamook at this hour, right now at 41 degrees. In fact, here's a look at the coast out in Lincoln City, 44 right now. Plenty of clouds in the area. And again, you're going to start to see some drizzle and some showers working in with a system that's going to start to impact us. So as we look at the satellite, pretty interesting to see. You could see the Cascades clear right now, and also parts of the coast range that's really talking about the inversion right now. So we're socked in the clouds and the fog in the valley. East of the mountains out towards the Dalles and the Gorge, some clouds. And as we look at the state as a whole, not really much going on right now, but a couple things to look at. We see the clouds increasing up towards the north and the east, and that's going to bring us our showers in. Now, a couple warnings to indicate right now. We have a high wind warning that is for parts of the I-84 corridor. This does include Highway 203 and 237. This goes until 10 p.m. We could get some gusts up to around 60 miles per hour, so be aware of that. And then that freezing fog advisory for parts of the Columbia River and the Gorge, that goes until 1 p.m. with the below freezing temperatures. So as we look at the rain and cloud forecast, we'll stay dry early, but then those showers start to work in the evening hours. Again, drizzle possibly around 9 o'clock, maybe a few isolated showers coming in after that time period. Tomorrow, though, colder air moves in. Our snow levels start to drop, so maybe 1 to 2 inches out towards the government camp area. The coast range between about 5 and 7 could get a rain and snow mix, and maybe here on the valley floor, we could get a few flurries, but then by that time period, I think most of the moisture will be out of here. But the one thing is we're definitely going to cool down tomorrow night for our low. So still a chilly day along the coast and in the valley with the chance of showers moving in. We'll stay dry east of the mountains and still watching for patchy freezing fog in the Gorge and government camp around 45 degrees. Of course, the higher you go in the elevations, the warmer and more sunshine you see. So we'll watch today and tomorrow against showers. Tomorrow night into Thursday, we really start to cool off, though some freezing fog possible Thursday morning, and then we really cool off Thursday night into Friday. We're going to have to watch the timing of the moisture and those cold temperatures, but we will stay wet at times on Friday afternoon and shower chances Saturday, Sunday, and on Monday with temperatures near 50 degrees. So, of course, we've been taking these pictures of the pets and their holiday gear. This is Rio waiting for Santa Claus sent in by Heather. That was a good one. And check out Elsie May and Mr. Oli here. That was really fun. I love the glasses on here. That was a really good one. And this is Mia's ugly meow sweater sent in by Karen. She looks like she knows how to pose, though. And this is Bella sent in by Jerry and Judy. Bella was trying to pick out the right Christmas tree as they got to the Christmas tree farm. So great pictures. We're getting lots in. I'll be showing them on air in the morning and afternoon. And of course, Bruce will be putting them on air in the evenings. I think I have about 50 more in my email to still show. So I'll be showing these
for days. Someone emailed me and I said, hey, did you get one from so-and-so? And you're like, I have no idea. We've gotten so many. I can't believe people were able to dress their cats in sweaters.
Oh yeah, I know.
From what I know
of cats. A lot of patience with the cats there.
A lot of patience, yeah.
And you could also go on our Coin homepage and look at we have a photo gallery too of all the animals and their pictures on there.
Nice. Okay. Well, up next, updates to two of the most popular wax figures at a famous museum.